list we go. The Beijing gold medalist, LaShawn Merritt, he's in five. London gold medalist, Kerani James, the quickest qualifier in six. And Van Niekerk, the reigning world champion, in eight.
How's this, lads? On your mark.
So up he comes. Van Niekerk, only George Roden in 1952, and Eric Liddell, part of the Chariot Safari in 24, have won off the outside lanes. But Roden came from lane seven, and Liddell came from lane six. There weren't eight lanes in those days, so nobody has won from lane eight. James gets set. Merritt set. Van Niekerk set. They're all set for the 400, the final. In the starter's hands. So how hard does Van Niekerk go? He can't see the others. He's got to run scared a little. Hudson Smith being gotted up by James early. Merritt, does he use that speed or does he hang on? Van Niekerk's normally very strong on the top turn. He's gone out very hard. So is James and so is Merritt. Cedinho pushing up for the three. A 1-2 and three. Van Niekerk leads at 150. Merritt's gone up to James. They're 1-2 and three. Cedinho behind them. Merritt's giving himself every chance. James will be strong. Van Niekerk leads into the straight. He's a metre in front. It's got to be quick. He's a metre and a half in front. He's 3 metres in front. Oh, look at this. It's going to be so quick. Van Niekerk, yes, have a look. He had to break the world record because he was smashing them.
Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Coming in, Bruce, there was so much talk of him being able to break this world record. We thought he could do it. We thought he could do it. He's just done it from lane eight. That is the most amazing race.
Nobody has ever won an Olympic 400 from lane eight. He did what Michael couldn't do in Atlanta and break the world record in the final. It is magnificent. Michael Johnson is 20 metres from us, Tamsin. He's right up there looking at it for the BBC. Well, Merritt and James, they gave themselves a chance. You just knew, didn't you? You just knew when he got two and then three and then 4 metres in front.
I think it was great that he was in lane eight. It meant that he had to really use that speed he has and take that first 300 metres out to a place he'd never been before. And he just didn't slow down, Bruce. He destroyed one of the best fields we've ever seen in a 400 metres.
Well, he's beaten two Olympic champions. That's never been done before. This is the greatest 400 metres of all time. He breaks the world record. He beats the two men that were the Olympic champions prior to him. And he does it from a lane that's never been won from before. This is what it's all about. South Africa has just had a golden moment. An incredible race. Astonishing. Close to breaking 43 seconds in the end. James and Merritt. Cedinho's got fourth. He's broken the national record, 44.01. Savander has run 44.25, the 18-year-old. Karmas has broken the national record as well. Taplin's run 44.45. Hudson's fifth, 44.61. Honestly, collectively, top to bottom, that's the best we've ever seen in the one lapper.
We've spoken twice this week. I asked you twice about the world record. You told me to wait until Sunday night. It was worth the wait, believe me.
Yeah, it's finally here, but I give the Lord credit for every single step out there tonight. I just asked him to take control and use me tonight, and I'm so grateful for the opportunity that he's given me and that I could finish the across the line with the world record. It's amazing.
Your greatest race, I think, obviously, but having to do it from lane eight as well.
I really didn't care. Tonight it was just about going out there and execute me as best as possible.
Well, you did it better than
Thank
anyone.
So much,
well done. Congratulations.
So Wade is smiling, and how happy will Coach Boy to be? Well done. 74-year-old great-grandmother coaches a world record holder. 43.03. It's actually hard to imagine. The first South African to win an Olympic gold on the track since 1928 and smashes Michael Johnson's record set in 1999. He was there to see it. Let's hear from him now.
This young man has done something truly, truly special. 43.03. That is something that I thought I could do, didn't get a chance to do it. Let's take a look at this and just analyze it. I think that being out in lane 8 actually helped him because he was able to run his race and run the race that he knew that he could run out by himself. There are no adjustments to make. You just run your race, and it's almost like running a time trial. This is a world record. This is a world record. And sure enough, oh my God, he breaks that world record. That was a massacre. What else can he do? Can he go under 43 seconds? This could be the new huge star of this sport.